Hello guys, good afternoon. So today I'm gonna update you what I did with the Hilux. Actually kakagaling ko lang sa Anilaw, Batangas, and I brought the car. The car is great, just like the Ranger, guys. I also brought that in Anilaw last year. Nag-diving kasi kami doon. And this car is fantastic, actually. I'm actually surprised that it's not as... Kasi, of course, online, people are saying tagtag talaga. Siguro sa likod. But, to be honest, when you're driving the car in the highway, well, highway is smooth eh. But even going up Anilaw, Mabini, that area, and there are roads na may mga potholes and stuff, I think the tire pressure does matter. I put mine at 29. 29, 30. Recommended yata is 33 or something like that. But 29 ang nilalagay ko na PSI. And maybe that helps. I didn't do anything with the suspension yet. I don't think I will ever replace the suspension unless it, ano, sira yung suspension, guys, yung shock absorbers. But that will take some time. But for now, guys, it's 546 kilometers. My PMS, my first 1,000, basta, I think it ends at October. So, ano na yun, July. So, I still have a couple of months before first PMS ko, which is 1,000 kilometers. Kasi free to until 20,000 kilometers. Anyway, let's start in the inside. The minor Lazada updates. Kasi Lazada lang naman yung binili ko. Okay, so this I bought in Lazada. So these are basically like rubber cup holder mattings. So, sakto siya. This was like, mura lang to, guys eh. Basta check nyo na lang online. Lagi mo, Hilux cup holder matting, rubber. So, it's good because it won't scratch the plastic underneath. At the same time, when you put drinks, it won't make a sound and stuff like that. Like keys, it won't rattle. Pag plastic kasi sa ilalim eh. It would be nice to find something like this also for this. But yeah, I'll try to research for that. Then I bought this, guys, kasi black gloss to. As you all know, this is black gloss. This strip. This part lang naman in this. So I bought this. Papakita ko sa inyo. Is a super clean. Ano ba to? It's like a, how do you call it? It's a, parang, hindi gel eh. Gel ba tawag dito? Like a, I'll show it to you guys. Yan guys, so it's like this gooey, slimy thing. Now you get a portion of it. Tapos, actually mabango siya. And it's not naman, well yeah, it's kind of sticky. Well, that's the purpose of it. So, yan. Antali natin. Yan. Ah! Grabe naman to. Yan, guys. So, it's basically like a slimy thing. But to be honest, just get a fabric pamunas. But, I don't know. It's a gimmick lang. I saw it on Lazada and said. So, it's basically like you dab it. Yan, tanggal yung dust. Ano? Tanggal, oh. Ano ba? Yan. So, you just dab it. And natatanggal na yung alikabok. Kasi as we all know, black gloss has a lot of alikabok. But I'm sure you could buy the, like the, like how do you call it? The screen thing that parang laminated thing to protect it. Yan. So, yan. That's what I do. Yan. Dab lang. Yan. Dito. Yan. So, I got that. Then the next thing I got is this, guys. This is, sulit na sulit. So, it's... Kasi when you get the Hilux, parang siyang deep ano lang siya, diba? So, this one's like a tray. So, and it has already the rubber thing. So, for... Basically, for your coins, dito, and whatever you wanna put your... Yan, yung RFID extra charger for Type-C or USB. And so, sulit to. This was around, I think... How much was this? 350 pesos? 400 pesos, guys? Depending on the... Kasi meron din GR, may nakalagay Hilux. Ito plain lang to, guys. So, yan. So, for me, sulit to. Lazada lang yan. What else did I put? Okay, so this there's a switch here, extra. And also on the side, guys, yan. So, papakita ko sa inyo. Because I added a light. Kasi I noticed in Anilaw, sa taas, going up. Sa mga resorts dun, sa mga dive resorts dun. Medyo madilim at night. Talaga madilim talaga. So, it would be nice to have extra light. But I don't want any LED bars on top. So, I decided to put this. So, this one, it's a switch. We'll turn it on. So, it will change colors. And I'll show you also how it looks. Sa, you know, the different colors. Tapos na yan. Yan guys, so now it's yellow. So, pag all weather. Then if you switch it. Switch natin ulit. Ayan, puti na siya. So, I replaced that. So, ginawa ko sa loob instead of sa labas. The reason for that is I want it to be hidden. Ayoko yung exposed yung ilaw. But most people, they expose. Nilalagay na sa labas. Sometimes they put it a bracket here. May ilaw yan. On both sides. But ako, nasa loob. I want it hidden. So, and it's not too strong. Sakto lang siya for, yun nga, like I said, pag super dark streets na walang ilaw talaga, walang street lights. Like some provinces, wala talaga. Especially yan, like Anilaw, going up. Very konti lang yung ilaw sa street lights. So, I think that's a good investment. That was 4,500. At Electrovox, guys, that's a pair na. Pair of lights, kasama na installation and the bracket. Okay, what else did I do? As you all know, I did, of course, rubber mattings. This was sobrang sulit. Why? Because, of course, nag-anila kami, nag-dive kami. We went on island. I spent time with my family and my girlfriend's family as well. And, of course, naka-chinelas and there was sand, di ba? And naka-diving shoes kami. So, pag-apak namin dyan, puro, ano yan? Puro, you know, stones and pebbles and sand. Kahit anong gawin mo, magkakaroon talaga, especially when you dock off the boat. So, it really helped catch all of that and it was easier to clean than having no rubber mattings. That was good. Then, of course, guys, so, I have the original antenna. Yeah, no? So, that is the shorter antenna. See the difference? Yan. So the reason why I did that, guys, kasi some parkings, especially the older malls, guys, talaga mababa yung parking. So I replaced that. Actually, Electrovox was kind enough to give that for free, and I have to pay for that. That was nice of them to do that for me. That's why I always go there. So yun. So it's like a shorter antenna for the Hilux. Just for para hindi ka sumabit sa parking space. Oh, ganda ng the modern BMW with the big kidney grill. Yan ang literally kidney grill ng BMW, di ba? 4 series yata yan. Yeah, 4 series. Which is, you rarely see that car actually. Anyway, on to that. Ano pa ba? Okay. So, of course, yung sa likod, yung tri-fold. But I have to unlock it kasi nga, naka auto-pop lock. So, you have to unlock it from the inside. Tapos, yeah. So, I used perfect yung tri-fold, guys. Kasi nga, I put some stuff here because we were diving in Anilaw. Tapos ito, dali lang, guys. Ha? I'll just show you how pag tri-fold. So, you just the lever and then you spin it around. Same goes with that. Then you just flip it. And that's how easy. To lock, same thing. Just align it and lock. That's it. Tapos may ilaw naman to yung Hilux. Ha? So, it's stock LED lights. You know. But if you don't have it, let's say, I don't know, with the G variants, then there's ilaw naman for the tri-fold here. malakas naman siya. So that was a good investment, the trifold. And this auto pop lock, which is inside. And this, of course, the garnish. Then, of course, ito, guys. Some people are gonna ask, Sir Ranger, I have the Hippotech Slim Visor. The reason why I got this, which is not the Slim Visor, this is the one outside. The typical visor, which is cheaper, this is 1 plus lang, guys, mga 1.5. It's because walang available na Hippotech Slim Visor. I asked Hippotech Industries, ang daming shops, wala talaga. And the one I ordered in Lazada, when I received it, was it, they had a crack. Basically, half of it was split. So, I got this. Maybe eventually I'll replace it with the Hippotech. Tapos ito, Lazada. So, basically, the sticker that para anti-scratch thing for the door handles. Of course, the ambient, you know, the amber lights for the grill. Diba? And, yeah, that's about it for now. For now, yun lang muna. Sige. Yun! Galing! Check ko ang kabila para balanse. Yan. Yun! Galing! Yan. Galing! Nice! You know, those are the simple accessories I added with the car. And like I said, I'm gonna do a lot of reviews. Of course, yung LED lights pala, I forgot. Yan, yung LED lights dito rin. If you wanna ask, that's 31mm bulb. And this was T10. Also, for the plate number, it's T10, guys. Just so you know. And also, for the lights dito, yung puddle lamps, is also T10. LED bulb, a lot of people are asking me, so yeah, T10 31mm. My tints are medium 3M, super dark 3M, pwedeng-pwede sa RFID kahit sa windshield. So yan, guys, kakalagay ko lang ng RFID. Actually, car has been very good, more than what I expected, because of course I'm comparing it with the Ranger, because the Ranger is It's a great pickup. It really is, in terms of the interior, exterior, the way it drives, how easy it is to drive. Andrea loves that pickup, and how comfortable it is, diba? But to be honest, in terms of power, and the next video will be about that. It's gonna be about the comparison between those two, because we have those two pickups, and I can compare and give you honest opinions about both. There's strengths and weaknesses, diba? But no car is perfect. And every person, when they buy a pickup or any car, preference yun eh. That's your taste, that's your preference, how it looks. Some people prioritize bigger engine, some people prioritize tech. Some people prioritize the brand. So Toyota, ang dami. Filipinos, pag Toyota, automatic, sinasabi, yun ya. It's reliable and all that, etc. Resale value and that. And also, yung availability of parts. Kasi nga, guys, to be honest, if you live in some provinces sa Malalaya, if you're not from Metro Manila, it may be hard to fix your car if you have a Subaru or a Mazda or a European car like Audi, BMW, Mercedes, Jaguar, etc. I understand that. That's why a lot of people would buy Toyota. Or maybe even Ford. Kasi ang dami na naka-Ford eh. In Baguio, ang dami naka-Ford Ranger. They use it panghakot and all that. Sagada, ganun rin. So, it really depends where you're from. And if you feel that's gonna be a hard time to get parts eventually for your car, then yeah, you're gonna go with a brand like Toyota, where mas madali mag-source ng pyesa, diba? Kasi importante rin yun eh. Especially if you only have one car or diba? Then you need to have it fixed agad. Diba? So, yan. I understand that part. So, there's not... I don't believe in brand wars. Some Toyota cars are not as good as other models. Diba? Not all Toyota cars are good. The same way goes with Mitsubishi. Same way goes with Ford. Same way goes with Mazda, Subaru. Diba Subaru? As, you know... High maintenance on Subaru and resale value is terrible in the Philippines. So if you want to sell the car, Subaru kind of reminds me of what Opel was, because when I had the Opel Astra Wagon before 2002, that car was, when we bought it, that was almost ₱1,000,000. This was 2002. Now when we sold that car, guys, I think it was 6 years old, ₱150,000. Because now, basically, Opel didn't do a good job in marketing the brand. At the same time, siguro parts were expensive. But the car was good, guys. This is the thing. We never had problems with that car, that Opel. Matibay siya and all. Pero yun ya, resale value was terrible. Because wala ng Opel. They were sharing. After Opel, nag-shut down yan sa Pasong Tomo. It shared a showroom with Chevy. And it was bad. So we sold it for $150,000. Imagine, after 6 years. So it does matter, guys. Because it's not... about the money at this, it's about actually selling the car, getting rid of the car. That hassle, because imagine you can't get rid of the car because nobody wants to buy the car unless you sell it for nothing, which what happened with the Opel. So it matters to most buyers. It does matter to say that resale value does not matter. It does matter. So that's why. But for me, it doesn't matter as much as other people. Of course, I want to sell the car. Kung gusto ko ng ibang kotse, gusto ko ibenta as fast as possible, then I want to sell it, right? But I also don't want to be ripped off, diba? I don't want to be taken advantage of. Kasi nga, hard-earned money mo yan, tapos, diba? You sell it for a fair price, that's fine. Depende how you use the car. But with this Hilux, we all know that if you sell this, hey, take care of it, most likely, ang bilis mo benta to. And a lot of people love the Hilux. Same goes Fortuner, Innova, Zenix, Land Cruiser, the new Toyota Prado's coming out, Alphard, Yaris Cross. I see Countess of Yaris Cross, Vios, Altis, lahat. High Ace, diba? Just like Andrea's High Ace Elite, super nice car. Very, very comfortable. I've driven it a couple of times already. But yeah, I'm the last person who would have bought this car, to be honest, guys. If you watch my channel, I wasn't really a big Hilux Fortuner fan. Actually, when Andrea sold her Fortuner, that was in 2016, I think. I told her to look at other brands. That's why we ended up buying the Nissan Terra. For that reason. We didn't, because when we saw the Fortuner, at that price, I think that was the G variant. It's very bare compared to the Terra VE. So, yan ang reason why we got the Terra. And we sold it because we wanted to buy another car. It's not because the car was terrible or anything. Sometimes, yeah, we sell it because we need the parking space and we can't keep all the cars. Diba? So, yun ang nangyari. And I'm just happy with this car. And it's not a car that I baby. Actually, when I was driving sa Anilao, nagkaroon ng mga... There was, you know, stone chips from a truck and it was hitting the car. I didn't care. Pero kung Mazda ko yun dati or yung sedans or yung Audi, I would be like, oh, the paint, diba? Kasi sakit. Pero with this, parang okay lang kasi pickup, everyday, you know. It's basically a workhorse type of vehicle. You don't really care about it. But of course, I'll take care of it. But at the same time, I'm not gonna be as, kumbaga, as delicate with the car. And yeah, my Camry is still for sale, guys. Just let me know. Nandiyan, nasa likod. Can't really see it, but it's there. And yeah, I'm very happy. I love this auto 360 view. I love the ito yung parking sa side. That really helps. Actually, and also, I will add to this video the tech of this car, the distance cruise control. Ay, fantastic. I'll add the video here. And yeah, that's the update and what I added with the Toyota Hilux. And I'll see you in the next vlog. So take care, guys. Bye-bye. Hey, guys. So I'm testing the distance cruise control for the Toyota Safety Sense. And galing guys, kasi I'm set at 105 kilometers. Nandito kami sa highway, so may star toll. So, ayan, may kotse kanina. So, it just slowly brakes. And it's not sudden. Ang ganda ng progression. It really gives a good distance. Siguro around, I would say, 3 cars. Before, ano, talaga the distance. Talagang safe ka. So, if you're a person who's, you know, you're not really good, you're not that alert when it comes to driving in the highway pag mabilis yung kotse, tapos yung magbe-brake yung nasa harap mo, this is perfect for you. Yan ang wala sa Ranger Wild Track. That I wish, sa 4x2 guys, but the 4x4 has it. But yung 4x2, which is priced almost the same as the Conquest 4x2, would be nice to have, no? Diba? Yan guys, so galing. So I'm at 100 now. But it's set at 105. As you can see, 105. Yan, may kotse pa rin sa harap ko. And yeah, yung pa ako, yan, just relaxing. Hopefully they slow down. Pero ganina guys, galing, nag-60. Bilang sisipa siya with the right distance, sisipa ulit siya back to 100-105. And now it's slowing down kasi the car in front is also slowing down. Galing talaga ng technology of most of the cars now, even you know, from Chinese crossovers to regular pickups, into even the Civic RS, which I had the same technology, babe. Yung Mazda 3 has that on the top of the line, I think. But yung mild hybrid, pero mahal kasi. Imagine, this is cheaper than the mild hybrid Mazda 3. Though, different segment, and the Mazda 3 would be more, of course, a sedan compared to a pickup. But maganda that this Hilux Conquest meron. Galing. Straighting you, to you, how it is. So, if you go on the this is the overtaking lane, so dapat dito tayo. But halos same yung speed, no? Kahit, so dito lang, you can practice it. So you see the pickup in front. Now it's 100. A little over 100. Ayan, bumibilis na tayo ulit. Then it slows down because there's a territory. Yan, no? Ayan, bigang nag-brake. Galing, no? Galing talaga ng technology. So, you can really relax your feet, guys, on long trips. Kasi galing kaming Anilaw. And of course, start all the way to SX na to eh. So it's a long stretch going back to Manila. So, yan, you could just rest and relax. Yan, may blind spot monitoring ka pa. Yan.